This is Mission Control Houston. On board the International Space Station, packing to come home has become the focus of activity for the crew, half of which is due to return to Earth this weekend after 4 months in space. On Wednesday, the International Space Station's mission management team met and conducted an undocking readiness review for Soyuz Commander Yuri Malenchenko and Flight Engineers Sonny Williams and Aki Hoshide to come home in their Soyuz vehicle. The MMT vote was go to bring 31 Soyuz home this weekend. The three crew members are due to undock from the station in their Soyuz vehicle on Sunday and land in Kazakhstan on Sunday evening U.S. time. Each of them has spent several hours over the course of the day on Wednesday packing the gear from their crew quarters and working together to stow those items and returning science samples inside their Soyuz vehicle. They're also continuing the daily exercise regimen that each of them has to counter the negative effects on their muscles of not having to work as hard as usual while they have spent all this time in a microgravity environment. Malenchenko, who is the commander of the Soyuz vehicle, spent the day overseeing the packing of items into 31S. He did spend some time, along with his two Russian colleagues, flight engineers Oleg Novitsky and Yevgeny Tarelkin, as they conducted a public affairs interview with a Russian television program. Flight engineer Aki Hoshide also spent time doing a public affairs event today. He was answering questions posed by Japanese college students who were gathered at the Scuba Space Center near Japan. Commander Sonny Williams spent the middle part of her day preparing hardware for installation of a new wireless access point for the station's wireless computer network. Flight engineer Kevin Ford spent part of his time doing a crew medical officer training. He also exchanged water in the enclosure that is supporting the Madaka fish for an experiment into how gravity impacts bone loss. And he also worked in the U.S. section of the space station installing a sensor kit for taking measurements of ultrasonic background noise. That is for an investigation that is developing the technology that can listen for air pressure leaks in the space station. But it will need to know what non-leak extraneous noise sounds like. And the kit that Ford is installing today is part of the development to do just that. Station maintenance will continue on Thursday with the crew members working in the Quest airlock and performing a software upgrade for the urine processor assembly. As the crew members move closer to this weekend's departure of three crew members and the beginning of the station's Expedition 34.